It is the Go Home Show for JJ Zone next week. I'm Bradley James, and welcome to ACL Prime live tonight from Austin, Texas. As I stated before, tonight is the Go Home Show for JJ Zone next week. We have a star-starred card tonight being run by Calypso, of all people, because Seto Kaiba, the current GM, is out for the week. Jeez, we're not wasting any time getting started with the Inner Circle, now are we? Because as it seems as though Mr. Kawarnagisa, or Tarbris, whichever he wants to be called by, is deciding to start the show by coming out to talk to the audience and taunt them like usual, I'm supposing. But yes, as I've said before, yes, Seto Kaiba is not in the building tonight, but his assistant and head of talent, Calypso, is, so it's going to be a wild and crazy evening for sure. But it seems as though Mr. Kawarnagisa is grabbing a mic, so he's going to want something to say. Oh great, here we go again. Yes, because that's totally original. Yes, yes, get it already. Wait, what? The hell are you going on about, Kaworu? The hell? Wait a minute. Is he implying it's in management? Wait. You don't mean. Ah, this old dance with the devil bull crap. Oh jeez, really? You're gonna quote that of all things? Seriously? Please, somebody shut him up already. Oh boy! Looks like he's not wasting any time to get into this as well! Yes, yes, thank you, Calypso. Yes, I do believe they are sick of hearing that as well. Thank you. Wait. Oh boy! This is gonna be fun! Who's gonna face off against? Oh boy! That's a big one! Face off against Tsukasa of all people! Jeez! Oh yeah, I think the fans are gonna love that. Oh, shut up about that, Kaworu. Really, your scrawny ass is gonna beat up Tsukasa? Please. Oh my god, just shut up about that. Yeah, that's right. We do have a show to run. And we can't have it with you just mouthing off in the ring now, can we? So get in the back, Tarbris. and welcome back to ACL Prime here, folks. And we are having one of our very first, one of the longest of our ongoing newcomers matches here tonight. Of course, we already know who Mr. Gintoki Sakata is, although we haven't seen him in a while, ever since the match a few weeks, about a month ago, I believe, against, in the number one contenders match between, what was it, Kite and Natsu Dragneel. We haven't seen him in a while since that, ever since Natsu almost took him out because of his assault. So it's good to see that Mr. Gintoki has returned. In fact, the man he's facing off against tonight, he's quite the newcomer in the world of co-op recently, and I do believe we're gonna have a better proper introduction to him later on in a few moments, but can we just appreciate the moment that Gintoki is fine and well after everything that's happened? This is, again, as I stated before, this is quite the surprise, as this man, Battle Ushiromiya, is a newcomer in the world of Kaw. This man has not been in Kaw before, as to my knowledge at least. Although I have been wrong about a few of the ones in the past, so maybe he has been in Kaw, maybe not, I'm not sure. But it's good to know that this man of all people decided to bring himself into the world of ACL at such a time like this. This man comes from the illustrious Ushiromiya family, as it were. And tonight, he makes his Kaw debut here in ACL against Gintoki Sakata. It's going to be one hell of a match, of a debut match he has up against him. These two men are starting off right now, and starting off with a real Kaw over tie-up between these two men. Headlock by Battle of Iron, sending Gintoki back down to the mat. Strikes it back at Gintoki by Battler, getting an early lead. A reversal by Gintoki, a reversal by Battler, and a reversal and a body and a back body slam by Gintoki right there. And Gintoki going for the assault. Battler reverses, going for the strikes. Gintoki reverses with an Irish whip. Gintoki, Battler reverses with a float over neck breaker. Gintoki getting up. Battler going for the top rope, and it looks like he's going. Yep, and he connects it. And he's just casually taunted to the fans right now. And Battle is sending Gintoki into the rope, into the turnbuckle with that arm and with that clothesline. Once again, taunting to the fans right there. And sending Gintoki into the ropes again once more. Gintoki reverses with a float over neck breaker of his own. Gintoki trying to get Battle now. What's he doing here? Battle trying to reverse, and Gintoki gets that. Sends him onto his back with a backbreaker. Gintoki goes to the assault, trying to gain the advantage right now. Battler sends him into the ropes, and a bulldog right there by Battler. And Battler sending his knee right into the head of Gintoki right there. And once again, a knee right to the head by Battler. Battler just casually taunting to the fans right now, going back onto the assault. Gintoki reverses it. And Battler reversing that by Gintoki. And Battler going on to the knee strike once again, but Gintoki reverses right there. Gintoki just trying to get the advantage once more onto Battler. Battler once again going to the assault, going to the top rope. What's he doing here? Oh, and he goes for a flying elbow drop. And Battler just casually taunting once more. Looks like Battler is just trying to get the advantage now. Oh, sending it back down. Oh, and he went for a signature move, but Gintoki reversed out of it. And Battler trying to gain back the advantage, but Gintoki gets him in an arm headlock once more. Bulldog by Battler. And what's Battler doing here now? It looks like he's going for the assault. He's going for a lion salt, my god, going for that lion salt. That was a mighty lion salt there, folks. And what's Battler doing now? He's sending Gintoki up. He's trying to bring him back up. Gintoki looks to be off. We have a bit of trouble there. What's he doing? What's Battler doing here? What's he doing? Oh, and Gintoki reverses it. He reverses the assault and a knee and a foot right to Battler's head. Another one right to the head. That's Battler and Gintoki trying to get. And Battler reverses it once more with an arm block, with a shoulder block. Battler once again going to the top rope, trying to get that assault going. And then. And an elbow right to the head connects. And Once again, Balor going for that assault and a knee right to the head of Gintoki. Once again, all take right to the fans here. Definitely showing off a cocky side right to the fans here. Running into the corner. What's he doing here? And Gintoki reverses, sending him right into the corner once more. Gintoki with that foot right to Balor's head again. Once again, going for the assault. Balor reverses out of it, however, and sends Gintoki into it now, going for the assault. What's he doing here? And a bulldog with that strike into a bulldog. Once again, taunting to the fans. Balor definitely making a good impression right now. And that in a stand against the Guri right out of nowhere. But Gintoki reverses and once again goes to the assault right on it, just smashing right onto Balor's head. My God. And Balor once again going for the assault right there. Gintoki, Balor reversing out of it with a belly-to-belly suplex. And Gintoki with a float-over neckbreaker right there. And Gintoki going for those head smashes once more. These two men definitely going at it. Gintoki definitely not showing any kind of ring rust for that matter. And Gintoki, what's he doing there? Oh, and a mighty float-over clothesline. Gintoki going for the pin. One. Only getting a one there, folks. What's he doing here? Oh, and just sending him up and over. And what's Gintoki doing here? Is he going to go for it? He's going to go for it. Oh, and that flying kick right to Balor's head. Balor just managing to break out of that with a pin. Let's see. Float over neckbreaker once more by Balor. What's he setting it up for now? He's going to go for it again. Lion Salt once more. And once again, he's going to go for that assault right now. What's he setting up for here? Golden Truth! Golden Rule! Go for the pin. One, two, three! And Balor wins his debut match here, folks. What an impressive show by both men here tonight as Balor wins his debut match here tonight. Gintoki not showing any kind of ring rust for that matter as he almost tried to manage to get Balor down at some points, but it just wasn't enough. He even got a two count. But Balor with that lion salt and into the golden rule there, folks. That signaled the end for Gintoki there. And definitely was a good show for it, as it were. But indeed, this is an incredible showing by the young lion here. And definitely a good showing for his first night here at ACL. The only question is, can that momentum proceed into later on matches here? Unfortunately, he still needs to work on that cocky little attitude of his, but we'll be right back after this commercial break for more action here on ACL Prime here, folks.
The owner and ruler of the world of NJCW. Now, I take it you like car wrestling. Not a shocker. I take it you like wrestling too. And maybe if you're a fan of like fantasy and shit, like comic books and movies and all that stuff, you pretty much would enjoy it as well. So I'm here with a pretty important announcement. This is NJCW. Now, then, you're probably asking yourself, well, this is not how a regular car commercial goes. Usually there's like, they show something from the show. Well, we have a small little thing for you, so check it out. I bet you did, because in that video there was a subliminal message pretty much telling you, hey, guess what, you have to like NJCW. And now you do, and now you're my puppet, and now you're going to go subscribe to the channel. Because why? Because you're my
dope.
And it looks as though that the team of Mio and Areta are ready for both tonight and at Danger Zone next week. But their opponents tonight are Mami Tomoe and Manaka Kaname of the Magic Quartet. Now, we have not seen Mami Tomoe in action ever since Big Bang, back when ACL first started. But Manaka Kaname, she is a newcomer here, as well as the other members of the Magic Quartet, and she is making her debut match here tonight alongside Mami. The question is, can both of them work together against the newly reformed team of Brenna and Mion here tonight, who have finally got Mion back to her old senses after everything that's happened? Only one way to find out tonight as this match happens. And here they come, folks! The number one contender for the Lioness Championship and her partner, Brenna Ryugu. We have not seen the real Mion Sozaki in action ever since the third edition of Prime, just before Full Metal Panic. So it's great to see Mion back in action and in the quite possibly the best psychological state that she's been in a long time. And Renna, oh boy, Renna hasn't been in a match in a while, so it's going to be great to see what these two can put together going into Danger Zone next week. And it's definitely going to be great to see what happens with Mion and her mental state once more, focused once more. And both Mami and Mion are starting for their respective teams here. Mami going for the assault first up, and Mion reversing. Going for the strikes onto Mami Tomoe right there. Going for a low dropkick, definitely showing her prowess once more. Showing that even setting her to the ropes, and not doing much. And a flying DDT right there by Mion. And a dropkick by Mion to follow up. This is definitely the kind of assault that she needs to bring in going into Danger Zone. And the reversal right there by Mion onto Mami. And another flying DDT right there. Definitely showing no amount of ring rust, and definitely showing her Renna holding it back as she goes to that headbutt. And Mami reversing it to her Irish whip into the corner. And Mami going for that top rope, and what's she going for here? Overcastle onto Mion. And Mami sending her into her corner. What's she doing here? Was going to go for the tag, but Mion reversed. Going for those shoulder blocks into the chest of Mami. What's she doing here? Oh, a knee right to the face of Mami. Jeez. That has gotta hurt there, folks. Oh, and a hurricane runner right there by Mami Tomoe. And just what is... And Mami going for the assault now. Kick right to the head once more with those legs. My god. And Mami tagging in Mannequin right now. What's she doing here? Oh, and a reversal right there for Mannequin. And Mia extending it back to her. Onto her side. Mannequin with a reversal and a big move right to the head. That's gotta hurt. Especially with those shoes on. God. And a tag right there by Renna. Renna is in for Himizawa, and a hurricane runner by Renna. And Renna going for the assault. No, Irish whipping Mami into the corner. Going for the assault. Oh, and a face buster right there. Oh, and spearing Manica onto the sidelines, out into the canvas. That is going to hurt, and a crossbody for the top rope. Renna definitely laying out her frustrations in this match. But Mami going for the reversal. Renna with the reversal as well. Going for the assault. And another face buster. Let's get going for the assault. Renna going for it. Yet another face buster right there. Renna definitely going for the assault right now. Taunting and definitely getting up. A reversal by Mami right there. Setting her into the corner now. And a tag right there. As Manica is set back in, and what are they doing now? And a trip and fall right onto an elbow drop. Basically, any other wrestler can do right now. What is Manica doing? And Renna's not happy with this. What's she doing for this X Factor Slam? But Renna seems to not be done with Manica just yet. Goes for another face buster. Manica gets up and reverses it as she goes for the attack once more. Once again, going for the assault. Reda going for the assault once more. Manica reverses. Going for the attack, and Seto goes to the corner. Reda reverses, but Manica Irish whips her once more to the corner. Manica just assaulting her with those knees and that footwork right there. A kick right to the back of Reda. Definitely going for the assault right now. And Manica definitely showing off the resilience. And Reda reverses. Setting her back down. And Mio just cheering on for her tag partner. And she is tagged back in. Mio going for the assault once more. Manica catching her off guard for those attacks. And Mio going back to the assault. Manica with a headlock and a drop kick. Onto Mio. Mio reversing once more. Going for a flying DDT once more right there. Mio going for a top rope maneuver here. Where's she going here? What is she doing? And a flying elbow drop from the top rope. And Manica going for the assault once more. Mio setting her back down. And once again working on that head again. Setting her back down once more. And what's she doing here? Mio definitely at a disadvantage with no shoes on in this match, as per usual. And Mio in trouble and getting a rope break there with that submission maneuver by Manica. And Manica, Mio reversing there. What's she doing here, folks? Trying to go for the assault. Manica reversing it, setting her up to the top rope. Oh, and Mio reversing in Manica's days. Oh, and a mighty clothesline for the top rope. Manica is in trouble here. Mio sending her to the corner. Manica reverses that. Mio reversing and stripping her back down. And what's Mio doing here? Just casually working onto Manica right now. Looks as though Mio is definitely working onto her as much as she can. Right on, looking on very happily at what's happening right now. And with that, and just tripping Manica right now. Once again, going for the top rope. Oh, and just barely missing an elbow drop for the top rope. Manica tagging Mami back in. Mami is back in against Mio right now, sending her into the corner and just going, oh, and a drop kick. And a reversal right there. And a flying DDT right there by Mio. Tagging Reda back in right now. And Reda back onto the assault onto Mami right now. The awesome teamwork of the Heat of His Own Games Club is definitely working up against the Magical Quartet. Oh, what a reversal right there by Reda. And a face buster once more by Reda. Tagging Mio back in. And Mio definitely going to go for the assault right now. What's she doing here, folks? Knee to the back right there. The Sotozaki knee to the back right there. And Manica trying to get involved in the smash, trying to distract Mio. What's she going to do here, folks? Reda ready to get ready for the assault. She's going for it. Oh, and she knocks right into Manica. She knocks right into Mami when she could have gone for Manica right there. An attack right there by both Mami and Manica. And once again, a trip and fall right into an elbow drop. Definitely something that literally anybody could do. And just what is going to happen right now. Oh, Manica is setting Mami up. Oh, and a fisherman suplex into a drop. Oh, and going for that pin right now. Manica somehow almost got a pin. And Mami going for the assault right... I mean, Mio going for the assault. And wait, she got the hot tag. She got the hot tag and she's connecting it onto Manica. Strike right to the head. And she connects it to Mami. And just what is Reda going to do right now, folks? What's she doing here? Oh, and a DDT drop. Tagging it back into Mio. And what's Mio going to do now here, folks? What's she doing here? Kick right to the face. What's she going for here? One, two. Oh, and Mami manages to make the save for Manica. This match is not over yet. Flying DDT by Mio. Trying to go for the assault right onto Mami there. Mio connects it. Go for the pin. One, two. Oh, and just managing to grab to break up the pin. Manica going back onto the assault right now. Wait a minute, she's going for the hot tag of her own. Once again, connecting onto Mio and connecting it onto Rena. Jeez, Mavi going for the assault right now. Once again, fly DDT right there by Mion. Gonna go for the top rope maneuver once more, going for a flyer. Oh, and she misses the flying elbow drop. Mammy once again going for the assault right here. What's she gonna go for right here? Oh my god, neck breaker right onto her shoulder. Going for the pinfall. One, two, breaking up the pin by Rena. And Manica going on to help Mammy. Going for the kick, going for that mighty kick, and she's going for the pin. One. Oh, he managed to get a one with the breakup by Rena here. Oh, and a hurricane runner right there by Mammy. But can Mio... Mammy's going for the assault right now, and a rope break right there. Managed to get some damage onto the chest. And Mammy with, and Mio with the reversal. Can Mio make the comeback? Flying DDT right there by Mio. Going for the top rope. What's that going to do? Oh, and she manages to get out of the way. Mammy tagging back in Madoka. So good, Madoka going for the pin. One, two, oh, and getting a kick out right there. Going for the headlock right there by Madoka. And Mio reverses it, setting her back down. And now Mio just casually going for the assault right now. And what's she about to do? What's she going to do? Oh, she's going for the knees to the back once again onto Madoka. Madoka reverses it. Irish whipping her back into the corner. What's she going to do here? She's going to tag back in Mavi. Going for a top rope maneuver. Wait, what's she doing here? Oh, and a crossbody connects. A team crossbody combo connects right there. Wait a minute, what's Mammy doing here? She's gonna... Oh, and she sends her right down. Mammy gonna drag her back in. Probably gonna go for the pin here, folks. Rena better get ready for that. Oh, and she makes for the save right there before the pin even starts. Mio going for the assault. Rena with a big boot right to Madoka. And wait a minute, what's she going for here? Sonozaki slam! And once again, going for the pinfall here. Gonna go for the pin. One, two, and Mac gets distracted and it makes the freak out. Mio and Rena win the match here, folks. Definitely a show of something to look forward to at Danger Zone in a few weeks, given what could happen. Given everything that has happened within the past few weeks between Mio, Rena, and Shio. Mio is finally back here, folks, and she might be ready to finally take on her sister at Danger Zone, given to what we've seen tonight. And yes, while she will not directly have Rena's help, this may just give her the confidence boost she needs in order to finally shut up her sister. But only time will tell here, folks. I mean, we do have to wait until next week to see if we do have a new Lioness Champion or not. But if my money's right on it, I think we may very well have a new Lioness Champion in Mio and Sonozaki next week, given to what we've seen here tonight. The confidence and Mio is back, and her confidence is back as well. And that is what is important here, folks. Because after Full Metal Panic, she effectively lost it. Wait a minute, what the heck's happening here? Wait a minute, what's Mio doing here? Ah, oh, Shear's at the front right there, and she's taunting at Mio, trying to get her attention, and wait a minute, Loya's trying to send her back. Wait a minute, folks, what's gonna be happening here? Ah, oh, folks, we gotta take a break, this is, oh my god! This is just ads. We'll be right back. And as you just heard, folks, Heihachi and Kazuya are challenging T. Daiguren for a match at Danger Zone for the tag team titles. But first off, Kazuya has a match against Levi Ackerman here tonight. And boy, what a match that would be if Team Daiguren were to accept for the match. I mean, this would be quite possibly one of Team Daiguren's biggest challenges, given who they would have to face off against. I mean, facing off against the Mishimas, of all people, to defend the tag team titles against, would be almost insane, considering their background. But we will find out after this match if they do accept. And here comes Kazuya Mishima with his father, Heihachi. This man was a former head of the Mishima Zaibatsu. He ran the second Tekken World Tournament, folks. And he is, of course, the son of possibly one of the greatest fighters in any kind of martial art today, Heihachi Mishima. And of course, we all know about the dreaded Mishima family bloodline, and he is in fact the father of another star here in ACL, the man who has currently been on a roll as recently, Jin Kazama. Unfortunately, what does that make for him being a part of this roster now, given that there are three members of the Mishima family bloodline on the roster? Does that make Jin an ally? Will he side with his own father? You will have to find out within the coming weeks, but tonight, this man right here has to face off against Levi Ackerman right now. And Kazuya, not wasting any time, just getting into the match right now, folks. Just going at it against Levi at this point, just completely demolishing him right now, and really not showing any kind of lack of physicality against him, for a better word. I mean, I was just kind of gobsmacked for a moment there because of how, you know, we have all of these stars here at ACL at this point in time, and it's just like insane how many we're getting on an almost weekly basis. I mean, given how many people we have in this league this far, it's absolutely insane with how many we've been getting this far, and just how they've been showing their prowess here. I mean, even though it was a pretty interesting run-in last week, the Mishimas are a very valuable asset in the world of Car, if I were to say so myself. I mean, Kazuya's son has already been a part of the ACL roster for quite some time now, and now his father and his grandfather are in here? That in its own right is an amazing feat for a friend to have, in my opinion. But like, if I could just say something for a moment, isn't it kind of strange that Kaworu Nagisa was talking earlier about this whole, about him planting seeds within ACL, and two of them have already sprung forth, and we've already seen them? And as he said that, these two came out last week. I mean, doesn't it seem, again, it's a little bit suspicious, if I do say so myself. Like, a lot of recent things going around with the Inner Circle recently. It's been kind of interesting to think about it, don't you think? Maybe I'm just the only one. But getting back to the match, Levi has Kazuya has mainly just been dominating this match thus far, folks. He has been making pretty much Levi his bitch at this point. Levi has been trying to fight back at certain points and reversing out of it just as much as he can, but it doesn't really last for long. I mean, having to deal with Kazuya of all people, as you can see, it's literally quite possibly a hard feat to try and lift Kazuya up after everything. Oh, and an eye break and an eye pull right there by Levi, trying to get the momentum there onto Kazuya. And a headbutt onto the arm by Levi. And Heihachi. And Kazuya, what's he doing here, folks? Oh, mighty punch right to the head. And that deathly punch, and he's punching it right to the ground. He's getting ready for it. He's setting him up. And that mighty drop right there. And he's just pumping himself right up here, folks. He's getting ready for it. What's he doing here? What's going on here? Go to hell! Mighty slam right there. That mighty go to hell slam right there. What's he going up here? Going to the top rope. Oh, and he went for an elbow drop. He went for that elbow drop and it doesn't connect. Levi managed to get it. Oh, what a reversal right there by Kazuya. Going up for a flying clothesline, but it was reversed by Levi, and Levi is on the offense now. Sending him right to the corner. Will Kazuya reverse? Reversing! Levi with a reversal dropkick. Kazuya reversing with a clothesline. And a flying clothesline once again by Kazuya. And going for the top rope now. Elbow drop and a connects right onto the chest of chest of Levi, and Levi with an eye rake reversal. Going for a clothesline once more, and a back, building a back suplex by Levi. My god, Levi Ackerman's trying his best right now. Kazuya with that reversal again, and a drop kick reversal by Levi, and a big boot by Levi. Wow, that was some reversal right there, and an eye rake right there by Kazuya. Reversal body slam right there by Levi Ackerman. And an eye rake by Kazuya this time, and a flying clothesline once again. Kazuya showing off his athletic prowess. Showing off that the Devil Gene is no business. And once again, going for that mighty punch right to the face. And my god, Levi is definite. What's he doing now? He's setting up for Aaron, and a going to hell slam right to Aaron. Levi's back up now, folks. What's Kazuya gonna do now? Heihachi's on the outside just waiting for it. Oh my! And just a lift up and a pump up body slam. My god, folks. And Levi just managing to kick out face to Aaron's distraction. Aaron getting a clothesline right for his troubles. Levi going for the pin right now. Kazuya getting out of it with absolutely no trouble. And Levi just trying his best right now to even up the odds on Kazuya right now. Oh, and he was trying to go for that. He was trying to go for a flying fist right to the head and a flying clothesline once more. And another big boot by Levi. But that doesn't last for long as Kazuya does an eye rake. And lifting him up once more. Kazuya gets lift up and is going for the pin. One. Only getting a one by Levi. Oh, and a clothesline setting it back down. And just working on the head right now, my god. Kazuya definitely not playing around anymore. Definitely just trying to make a pure example out of Levi Ackerman here, and another flying clothesline. And wait a minute, what is Kazuya doing here? What's he doing here? He's doing it to Aaron now. Oh, and a mighty punch right to the head by Aaron. And what's he doing now? He's going for it once again. That holy crap! Garnell slam right onto Levi once more. And Aaron is distracted. He's just barely getting up. And Kazuya gets the free count right there. And Kazuya wins for the Mishima Zaibatsu. And Kazuya in his debut match manages to make a fine example out of Levi Ackerman here tonight. Now the question is, can he make that example? Can that example be enough to get an answer out of Team Daiguren here tonight. And there he is, Heihachi, congratulating his son for the win here tonight. And I honestly feel like Team Daiguren should not accept this given what they had to go through last week and given what we've just seen. I mean, yeah, Team Daiguren have been successful thus far, but who's to say they won't be successful up against the Mishimas if they accept this challenge? It's just like... Wait a minute! Here they come and they're getting revenge for what happened last week! Just sent them back down! I do believe that they have accepted the challenge here, folks, for Danger Zone!
This is a call of honor.
You're watching the COH Network.
Fire up.
And we are back here at ACL Prime here, folks. And now it is time to have Kawara Nagisa's very first match here, folks. As stated by Calypso earlier tonight, Kawara Nagisa is going to be facing off against our current crossover champion, Tsukasa, here tonight. And my god, folks, we may just see, quite possibly a preview of, may just see the very slaughtering of the leader of the Inner Circle here right now, and here comes the man himself! Here comes our current crossover champion, folks, the phenomenal wave master himself, Tsukasa. Now, a lot of people, I'm going to give credit where credit is due here. Tsukasa has been quite possibly one of the best champions here at ACL thus far. I mean, yeah, sure. Possibly one of the best champions that we have right now. I mean, look at this guy. He has taken out a lot of people ever since joining the ACL roster. I mean, have you seen his previous wins? He has been on an absolute streak right now, and unfortunately has to face off against Rudo Kimura in Danger Zone. But tonight, I get the feeling we're going to be seeing quite possibly a great massacre of Kawara Nagisa here tonight. Because right now, we have one guy who is the leader who just attacked this man right here last week, and I think he just wants a little bit of revenge. And this is just going to be a fun match to watch here, folks. So sit back and have a bit of a popcorn, because we're about to see quite possibly one hell of a match right now. And he goes for the senton right away. Kawara setting him up for reversal, going for a close eye right to the back there. And Tsukasa with that reversal to the head. Reversal kick right to the head. Kawara going for a headlock. Tsukasa sending him right down. Tsukasa going for those strikes into the corner. Kawara sending him into the corner. Tsukasa reversing by spearing him right into the corner. And Kawara with that reversal and a float over DDT by Kawara. And Kawara just trying his best here just to make sure that he can stick it out. But Tsukasa not wasting any time, just going on to the assault once more. But Kawara with that reversal, jeez. And Tsukasa just trying his best to get to land some hits onto Kawara here. It seems like... And a rolling senton there. Oh, and a neck breaker by Tsukasa going up to the top rope. What's he doing here? Oh, and a flying thunderbolt right onto Kawara, sending him into the corner. What's he doing here? Going to the middle rope, and a flying DDT from the middle rope there, folks. What a mighty strike there by Tsukasa. Definitely not wasting any time. Setting it back down. And Tsukasa with another neck breaker onto Kawara Nagisa. Kawara reversing. And Kawara going for the back now. Tsukasa reversing and headbutting him right onto the chest. And Kaworu reversing once more here, folks. Kaworu once again going for those strikes, but he's reversed by Tsukasa. Cool. Tsukasa definitely just showboating to the crowd right now, showing up, and a Kaworu will tie up pretty late into this match. And Kaworu going in, sending him. Oh, and an elbow right to the chest by Kaworu onto Tsukasa. Tsukasa, oh, and another reversal slam by Kaworu. Kaworu once again trying his best here, folks. Oh, what an enziguri by Tsukasa! Definitely a well-rounded strike right there by our current crossover champion. And a reversal right there by Kaworu trying to get himself back up, and it doesn't work. Tsukasa's back up. Doesn't manage to connect the strike. Kaworu going for that headlock once more, and an elbow right to the head for his troubles. Going to the top rope. What's he doing here? Flying over! Flying thunderball right there. What's Kaworu doing now? Oh, what a neck breaker right there by Tsukasa. What's Tsukasa doing now, folks? Oh, what a dragon salt right there by Tsukasa, going for the pin. One, two. Oh, and just barely getting a two. And wait a minute, he's going to finish him off here, folks. He's going to probably finish him off here. Right the wave, and that busted Kaworu right open, I'm pretty sure. Is that blood? Oh my god, Kaworu's busted open, and what the hell, he just kicked out? Kaworu just managed to kick out, and he's busted wide open, what the hell? Oh, and round to the head once more. Tsukasa going back in, setting him up into the fisherman's position. Oh, and a fisherman suplex. Showboating to the crowd right now, definitely loving this match thus far, and a leap of faith once more, it does not connect. Kaworu definitely trying to make a reversal here. Tsukasa going for a reversal of his own, just striking. And another neck breaker right there by Tsukasa. Once more going for the assault onto that bloodied head of Kaworu. Going up for the assault there. It's just amazing how he's just continuously going for the strike. And a reversal right there by Tsukasa, once again showboarding to the crowd. And into the corner, Kaworu goes, reversing and sending Tsukasa to the corner, and he's sent right back into the corner. Lots of reversals there, lots of weaseling out by Kaworu. Tsukasa reversing up, and oh, and an enziguri right there by Tsukasa. And wait a minute, what's he doing now? Is he going to do it one more time? Oh, wait, what? Oh, and a reversal DDT right there by Kaworu. Kaworu trying to send Tsukasa up here, folks. And trying to go for that punch to the head. Bulldog right there by our crossover champion. Once again, going for the head strikes there. Oh, that has got to hurt. And going right there, going right back to the assault Tsukasa does. And Kaworu just all bloodied and beaten up at this point, definitely not happy with us. And a reversal once again by Tsukasa, and another neck breaker. Once again, showboating to the crowd, working the arm right now, definitely loving what he's doing right now. And a reversal right there by Kaworu right to that chest. That has gotta hurt. And a reversal once more by Tsukasa. What's he gonna do here, folks? What's happening? Oh, and a second enziguri there by Tsukasa. Is he gonna go for it once more? He is sending up Kaworu here, folks. Is he going to go for it? He's going to go for it a second time. Is he going to go for it once more? And hey, wait. Wait a minute, what's happening here? Oh, Finn! Out of nowhere there, folks. Just spearing Tsukasa from out of nowhere, interfering in this match. And it's just despicable what's happening here. And Kaworu just calling for Rin to go and grab a chair once more. They're going to weaken him up, like you said before, danger zone. And hey, wait a minute. Hey, here comes Kenshin. Here comes Kenshin to break it up, sending him back once more. This match has been abandoned here, folks. What a shame.
I went out there, gave him the ass whooping of a lifetime, beat his ass.
You see, you're down here. You're trying to be on the A level, but you see, I'm on the double A level.
I have had enough of you trying to screw me out of every fucking thing I do in this company.
Maybe after the show we can step into my office and work something out. I know you're a reasonable man.
Absolutely shocked. Shocked and appalled. appalled at the amount of disrespect that you showed me.
Well then, the feeling's fucking mutual. Because I certainly do not want your respect either.
I will beat you, motherfucker.
The pin is mightier than the sword.
I will leave you laying in the pool of your own blood.
I'm coming for you, baby. And after that, it's time for some fun.
The danger zone that's coming up for next weekend, folks. And boy, do we have a card lined up for the Lioness Championship. Mirin Suzaki will reenact her rematch clause in order to get a match against her sister Shio for the Lioness Championship. Who will be the better Suzaki sister? And just made, it's Kawara Nagisa versus Kenshin Himura. Will Kenshin be able to show up the supposed leader of the Inner Circle, or will Kaworu manage to win? And then it's Tsukasa versus Rito Kimura for the Cross Servant Championship. Can the Blue Exorcist manage to beat the Phenomenal Wavemaster? We'll find out in Danger Zone. And then, having accepted the challenge earlier, Team Daigurin will defend the titles against the Mishima Zaibatsu. Can they outlast the Mishimas at Danger Zone? We will find out, or will the Mishimas manage to win? And then our main event, it's Spike Spiegel defending the ACL Championship against Sebastian Michalis. Will the Inner Circle manage to get the ACL World Title? We will find out next week, folks. But coming up right now, we have our main event here at ACL Prime. Sebastian Michalis taking on the Black Swordsman Guts. And I'm saying this right now as somebody who is really getting into this whole hype right now. I'm honestly hoping that Sebastian Michalis is not, that Spike Spiegel is ready for Sebastian Michalis, folks. Because, oh my god, he's going to have to be prepared with what he's been going through and what's been happening over the past few weeks here on Prime. Especially given the fact that Spike has spent the last few Primes laid out after the show. I mean, that's just insane given what's been happening recently. But the big question is, can Spike even manage to beat Sebastian after everything that's been happening? But of course, we do have tonight's match to see what's been happening. I mean, sorry, I'm just a little bit out of it with what's been happening throughout these past few weeks, and like, it is insane. I mean, I can't be the only one who's thinking, what the heck is Guts even getting himself into tonight, but you never know, maybe Guts might be able to knock out Sebastian before the match, you never really know. But who knows, the Black Swordsman does have a chance to get his hands on him tonight. But will that be enough to soften up the Black Butler here? And Guts going straight for it, and Sebastian just simply going at it. And a reversal right there by Guts. And Guts just going at it onto Sebastian right now. Sebastian going for that clothesline, and Guts reverses it. Guts definitely showing what he can up against the Black Butler here right now. And Guts, and Sebastian with that reversal and a knee right to Guts. Guts reversing out of it, and a gut, and a knee right to the gut, and a flying DDT right there. And going up to the top rope, oh, and a flying armbar! Oh, and a senton right, and an arm drag right there by Guts. Guts getting thrown down by Sebastian, and Sebastian just going at it once more. Running closer right there by Sebastian, once again going for the assault, and Guts sending it back down. And Guts just trying to maintain control of this match, but Sebastian is not having any of it, and just goes for the attack once again. Guts just going at it once more. Once again, just going for the assault onto Guts, but Guts trying his best. But once again, Guts and Sebastian just going back and forth in this match. It's really just a definite back and forth contest between these two men right now. I mean, it's just amazing that, once again, this type of match can even happen. The Black Swordsman versus the Black Butler. And just Sebastian definitely showing control of this match, and a spear right onto the announce table. Jesus! Holy crap, that is gonna hurt! Even if you're like someone like Guts, that would have to hurt given what's been happening. And a clothesline right there by Sebastian. Sebastian going to the top rope. Guts just manages to get out of the way. And Sebastian just going for the assault, and Guts reversing out of it, going for the arm. And Sebastian with an arm. With a shoulder block right onto Guts, going for a clothesline once more, but Guts reverses it. But Sebastian reverses out whatever Guts was trying to do there. He goes to the assault once more with a flying DDT. And what is Sebastian doing now? He's just going for the assault once again. And going for a belly to back suplex, sending it back down onto the ground. Guts definitely trying his best to stay alive in this match right now after everything. And wait a minute, what's happening here? What's Sebastian setting up for here? Butler bomb! My god, what a mighty Butler bomb right there by Sebastian, going for the pin. 1, 2, Guts just bashes a kick out of it just at the last moment, setting it back down there, folks. Sebastian going right back to the assault, just taunting Guts here, folks, going for the headlock. And right onto the gut of Guts with that knee. Once again, going for the assault, just taunting and taking his time with Guts right now. Possibly trying to send a message right to Sebastian Bicalis here. Knee right to the head. And definitely just trying to soften Guts up, as to say, this is what's going to happen at Danger Zone. And as much as I would like to think that Spike could survive after everything he's done thus far, with what we've seen in the past few weeks, can Spike even make it to Danger Zone? I mean, Spike has been laid out. He has been beaten with chairs. He's been absolutely assaulted in the past few weeks. And what's he doing now here, folks? What Sebastian doing is trying to drag him right to the ropes, and it fails to get him over there. Guts reversing it. And a reversal right there by Sebastian. And Sebastian sending it back down with that belly to back suplex. Right on, sending it face first onto the ground. And once again, oh, and a reversal right there by Guts. And Guts is going for the assault again.
Oh, and sending him down with a spine buster. That could be down. That could be game for Guts right there. Guts going for the pin. One. Only getting a one. Only getting him down. And Guts just sending him into the corner now. Trying to maintain the leverage onto Sebastian here. And Sebastian. Oh my god. What's he going for here? Oh, and a mighty jerk slam by Sebastian onto Guts. He's going for that pin now, folks. One. Two. Three. And Guts didn't really stand much of a chance against the Black Butler, unfortunately. And Sebastian managing to pull out one more win in his book before Danger Zone. And just, this could be the sight at Danger Zone. It's just, seeing what's been happening, it's just amazing just to think about what could happen at Danger Zone. If Spike is not careful, if Sebastian does manage to pull out a dominant win over Spike at Danger Zone next week, it could be disastrous. But again, we do have Calypso as the special guest referee of sorts. But even then, can that even be enough to suffice? Given what we've heard thus far, the suspiciousness that's been happening recently? I mean, what could happen next week, folks? It's just insane to think about what could happen, and that would end the show here, folks. But hey, wait a minute! There's Spike Spiegel, and he's getting some revenge for the last few weeks. He's just been trying to take the vengeance back onto Sebastian here, folks. He's just setting him out onto there. He's going to try and take him out right now. Go for a DDT strike here. He's going to go for the top rope now. Wait a minute, what's he doing here? Taking a sweet old time. Wait, Sebastian's getting up here. Wait a minute. No. This could be what's happening here, folks. Choke slam. No. We're running out of time here, folks. We will see you next week for Danger Zone.